It is amazing to watch because in our democratic system in Australia, we are used to politicians having to front up to press conferences and interviews all the time. Yet, as you say, Kamala Harris is getting away with this because she can. And incredibly, some media are actually defending this strategy. Have a look.
What has struck me since Donald Trump's press conference is sort of the highbrow nature of the press coming at Kamala Harris, saying, "Well, she, in my view, whining that she hasn't, she doesn't talk to us, she hasn't done a sit down with us, she hasn't done interviews with us." Right now, is there a real need for her to sort of, you know, get the imprimatur of the press on her campaign?
Yeah, the media making the argument for the lack of scrutiny, which is extraordinary, Kristin, because it's not about the media. It's not about fronting up to the media. It's about fronting up to the public, to voters, to opening yourself up to democratic scrutiny for the sake of voters.
Right. Well, I mean, at this point, the media is just an arm of the Democratic Party, so it's not particularly surprising. And make no mistake, Chris, if she does do a sit down, she's going to choose a journalist who won't ask her any tough questions whatsoever. But the big question is the one you posed earlier, which is, will this honeymoon phase last long enough to get her across the finish line? And there's a very real chance that it will. Most of the time, these candidates are, of course, picked way earlier in the process, at least even if it's not official that they would be the candidate, we would know months earlier who the candidate would be. So that honeymoon period will have usually a 4 or 5 month time frame, and then it kind of dies down and things go back to normal. But because the Democrats have pulled off this coup by forcing Joe Biden out and forcing in Kamala at the last minute, they may just pull it off where they get to that election day before the hype has died down. It's yet to be seen. I'm not sure, but it's possible.
We will see. I think you're right that Donald Trump needs to find his target, find his line to attack Kamala Harris on these issues of substance. And while he hasn't really been able to do that so far in his public comments, some of his advertising is attacking her record on policy. Have a look at this.
I am Kamala Harris. My pronouns are she and her.
You're considered the most liberal United States senator.
Actually, the nonpartisan GovTrack has rated you as the most liberal senator.
Do you have any plans to visit the border?
We are going to the border. We've been to the border.
You haven't been to the border.
I haven't been to Europe.
I am in favor of saying that we're not going to treat people who are undocumented cross borders criminals. That's correct. That is correct.
Well, there's the clue there, Kristin. It's all there in his own ads. Donald Trump's got plenty to work with.
Yes, this is exactly the line that Donald Trump needs to take. The Donald Trump campaign is doing a fabulous job. Unfortunately, it's Trump himself who can't seem to stay on message. And you know it pains me to say that. I badly want Trump to win this election. I think the future of the country depends on it. And hilariously, Chris, while all of this is going on, Kamala Harris is running ads claiming that she's a big border hawk. She's literally running to the right of Trump on the border as migrants pour into this country by the millions. So she needs to be called out on this issue and many others. If this becomes a popularity contest about who's the kinder person, who's more popular with the celebrities, who's younger, Donald Trump will lose. He needs to save his campaign and step up with the messaging. But I love that ad, and I hope that he can sort of imitate that messaging day to day when he talks to the press.
There's a long way to go still, Kristin. We'll see how it all unfolds. Thanks so much for joining us again.
Thank you very much, Chris.